So, Mr. Avi Noam Ezra Cohen, let's do another interview because the people are loving these interviews to hear what a true heart of a Saba, which means that Noam was born here and raised here and was in the army. What did it mean when you heard the word Christian?
Okay, well, in my youth, I'm still young, but during like high school or junior high, the whole image of Christians was what we saw in movies or what you see in the old city. Monks, people that are dressed in black, the Catholic. The Catholic Church, that was what we thought Christians are like.
Okay.
And in my family as well,
And so as you saw all of their big crosses and it instead of drawing you, did it make you...
No, it makes me sick to my stomach. Yeah. I felt like I'm going back to the Middle Ages.
Right,
and
right.
And that is always so repulsive.
Yeah.
And we did visit churches in Jerusalem. We went to see churches and I saw how...
Like on a field trip or something.
Yes, yes, yes.
Right.
During history lessons.
Right.
We went all around Jerusalem and we got into churches and just to see... And this high ceiling and, you know...
But it was all Catholic churches?
All Catholic,
okay.
Yeah. It's all Catholic. I didn't know anything else.
Okay.
For me, Christians was Catholic.
Okay,
period.
Catholic. And still people in the land...
Yeah, still to this day, I believe many still think like that because they have their busyness and, you know, the security issues of the land. So you don't really think about spiritual things unless you are coming from a spiritual company, you know, family.
Right.
But if you're coming from secular family or conservative, you just focus on your work, your life.
Right.
You don't think much
and surviving.
About such things. Yes.
And basically surviving.
Yes.
So what happened to you in high school?
So in high school, during our history lessons, the teacher told us that we were going to learn about the New Testament. She knew that there were some people that are really religious, so she said, anybody who wants to leave the class can leave the class, because this is not going to be in the test. I was one of the students that stood up and left the class, because I told myself, I'm not taking part in that Christian book. I didn't know what's written in it, but for me, it was out.
Because you thought it was another God.
Yeah, I didn't even think what God they were thinking about, you know, and for me, I didn't even think about Yeshua being a Jew, you know, it didn't even come to my mind. It was just Christianity.
Because they said, probably you heard more Jesus than Yeshua, right?
Yes.
So when you hear Jesus, it doesn't...
And in Hebrew, if we translate it, you call it Yeshu.
Which
and,
is bad.
Yeah, Yeshu is abbreviation that the Jews, secular, the religious Jews had made, which is abbreviation of may his name
be wiped out.
Yeah. So it's not Yeshua, like I'm saying it now.
Right.
See, Yeshua is immediately tells you this is about salvation. His name immediately tells you this is salvation. So, no.
This is so... So now that you are grafted in as a natural branch... what's your heart? What do you want to say? What do you want to say actually to Christians?
To Christians, well, first of all, any Christians I have met in United States, I tell them, you have to come to Israel. Because you're ambassadors of Christ to the lost sheep of Israel here.
Yeah.
What happened to me can happen to anybody else. You see, I accepted the Lord through an American pastor who came to Israel with a tour group. And they came to the store where I was working. So that's why I'm telling every Christian, need to come to Israel, put your feet here.
Yes.
Don't think just about yourself, but your callings is bring the Jews to the Lord.
And it's to provoke them with jealousy, not with all the contraptions, but to provoke them to jealousy that we have become a part of the covenant. Now we pick up as if, just like Ruth, just exactly like Ruth, your God will be my God, your people will be my people, is a perfect visual of all of it.
Right.
Well, now that you're a natural branch grafted into the tree of life, you're a natural branch. I'm a wild olive branch.
That is so true.
Do you realize, Noam Cohen, that we can snuggle together and it's legal? It's kosher.
And it's spiritual.
And it's spiritual because we're married. Yes. So natural branch, if you see a natural branch in the tree of life and a wild olive branch beside him and we're snuggling, just know that to us we're in the Garden of Eden because
yes.
we are in
love.
Love. Thank you. Thank you, Norm Cohen.
You're very welcome, my dear. God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.